In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers. Om, welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's readings. It's the 22nd of February, Saturday of the 6th week in ordinary time. And today we celebrate the feast of Chair of Saint Peter. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew chapter 16 to 19. At that time, when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do men say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter replied, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And I tell you, you are built on this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear brother and sister, Peter's confession and Jesus' passion prediction mark a watershed moment. From this point on, there is no turning back for Jesus, for Peter, and even for us. Today we celebrate a very interesting feast, the Chair of Saint Peter. This feast is not exactly in honor of a person, as most are, nor of an event, as others are, but of a chair. Of course, we are not commemorating a piece of furniture is chair-like, chairman, a position, an office. We celebrate today the founding of the position of the leader of the church. Jesus Christ is the head of the church. This office in no way replaces his office of high priest or king. God did not need Noah to build the ark, and he did not need Simon Peter to lead. He chose to allow us humans positions of dignity as co-operators of his grace. Peter made the profession, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And after this profession, Jesus renames him Cephas, which in Greek is Petros. Jesus bestowed to Peter a special place among the apostles. He was one of the three who were with Christ on special occasions, such as the transfiguration of Christ and the agony in the Garden of Gethsemane. He was the only apostle to whom Christ appeared on the first day after the resurrection. Peter, in turn, was often the first to answer. However, he was not without faults and was thus reproached often by Jesus. The church in its 2000 years of history has seen glorious events, challenging conflicts, turbulent times and dark moments. But the very fact that the church has survived those moments only goes to show that the Pope, successor of Peter, draws his authority, and that the Spirit of Christ is even today guiding the church. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for the gift of the Pope, and help him exercise his authority through service. Amen. Today being Saturday, a day dedicated to honor our Heavenly Mother, let's pray the Novena prayer to Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Holy Mother of God, we greet you as Queen and Mother of Carmel. You were raised from being a lowly handmaid to the great dignity of Mother of Carmel. As an act of filial homage, we glorify the Holy Trinity by honoring you, and in our many needs, we have recourse to your protection and your powerful intercession. Jesus, your Son, was so obedient to you on earth, will certainly grant your petitions on our behalf. With this trust and unbounded confidence, we beseech you to hear our prayers and obtain for us of your divine Son the favors we request in this novena. Having experienced the efficacy of your prayers, we are full of confidence that you will gain for us this favor, if it is for the glory of God and for our good. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our Lady of Mount Carmel, pray for us. Thanksgiving prayer. Holy Mother of God and Queen of Carmel, we, your children, come before you in a spirit of filial devotion and gratitude. As Mother of our spiritual life, you have obtained for us innumerable graces and blessings from our Heavenly Father, who has given to us through you the greatest of all treasures, Christ our Lord. We recognize with deep sentiments of thankfulness all the spiritual favors that have come to us through your powerful intercession. In particular, we thank you for your special protection over those who wear your holy scapular with faith and love. And finally, we thank you for answering our prayers in our personal needs. We implore from you the great grace of final perseverance, that we remain faithful to the end to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is God and ever. Amen. Pray for God's blessing, my dear friends. May the Lord Jesus be with you to defend you. May He be with you to sustain you. May He go before you to show you the way. May He follow you to guard you. May He bless you with the Father and the Holy Spirit, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Today, as we see in the Bible diary, Akash Pinto from Bengaluru, Lynette D'Souza from Mira Road, Mumbai, Margaret Hilda D'Souza from Dubai, Rakesh D'Souza from Permanur are celebrating their birthdays. We wish them happy birthday, and also among the listeners who are celebrating their birthday today, wish you all a happy birthday. May God bless you. Henry and Gracie D'Souza from Heranje are celebrating their silver jubilee of the wedding. We congratulate them and we pray for their families too. And we remember Basil Matthias from Manchakal Shirwa, whose death anniversary is commemorated today. May the Lord grant him eternal rest. This is your Father Stifan Perera, Carmelite priest. Wish you all a blessed day, a feast of the chair of St. Peter, and also a great weekend. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.